ALDHbr is a non-toxic reagent system that allows for identification of viable cells that express aldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme, or ALDH. Stem and progenitor cells, isolated from various normal tissues, as well as some primary tumors and cancer cell lines, have been reported to contain high levels of ALDH activity. Because of its unique ability to detect the intracellular marker without compromising cell viability, ALDHbr enables researchers to explore the functional properties of ALDH bright cells. During the assay, cells are treated with botepi-aminoacetylaldehyde that freely diffuses into cells, and it is selectively converted by ALDH to a non-toxic fluorescent compound, botepi-aminoacetate. This substance is retained in the cells in the presence of an appropriate ABC transporter inhibitor. Cells treated with diethylaminobenzaldehyde, or DEAB, which is an ALDH inhibitor, are used as the negative control. ALDH bright cells are then detected by flow cytometry. The ALDHbr assay was originally developed and optimized for detection of hematopoietic stem and progenitor cells in human cord blood, bone marrow, and peripheral blood. For detection of ALDH activity in non-hematopoietic and cultured cells, different assay conditions may be needed to achieve optimal results. The recommended cell density for detecting ALDH activity in hematopoietic cells is 1 million cells per milliliter of sample, but this may not be necessarily optimal for other cell types. For example, to detect ALDH activity in the SKBR3 mammary tumor cell line, which is known to have high ALDH expression, a cell concentration of 100,000 to 200,000 cells per milliliter of sample resulted in the strongest fluorescence. The incubation time with ALDHbr is also very important for detecting ALDH activity. For hematopoietic cells, the recommended incubation time is up to 1 hour at 37 degrees Celsius. For SKBR3 mammary cells, optimal results were achieved with cells that were incubated for only 30 to 45 minutes. Incubation for 1 hour actually resulted in lower fluorescence intensity. To prevent efflux of the activated ALDHbr reagent and the reaction product, ALDHbr buffer contains efflux inhibitors that inhibit the activity of ABC transporters expressed in hematopoietic stem and progenitor cells. As different cell types may express different ABC transporters, it may be necessary to test various inhibitors. Recommended inhibitors include 50 to 100 micromolar verapamil, 2.5 millimolar probenecid, or 100 millimolar 2-deoxydiglucose. ABC transporters are also inhibited by low temperatures. To prevent loss of fluorescence intensity, we therefore recommend keeping the cells on ice or at 228 degrees after completion of the ALDHbr reaction. This would include keeping the cells chilled during cell sorting. Incubating a cell sample with ALDHbr in the presence of ALDH inhibitor DEAB is an essential negative control in all ALDHbr experiments, and it is necessary to distinguish cells with high ALDH activity from cells that display background fluorescence only. It is also important to identify and gate out dead and late apoptotic cells by staining the ALDHbr reacted cell sample with a viability dye such as propidium iodide. Dead and apoptotic cells do not retain the fluorescence signal and may show up as ALDH low or ALDH negative in flow cytometry diagrams. When staining a population with heterogeneous ALDH expression, it is important to determine whether the differences in fluorescence intensity are caused by differences in ALDH activity in viable cells or by the presence of dead or apoptotic cells in the sample. ALDHbr assay conditions may need to be optimized for every new cell type. While we're unable to provide validated, optimized conditions for ALDHbr assays of every cell type, we can help you to achieve optimal results in your experiments. Our technical support representatives are highly skilled in cell biology and flow cytometry and will be happy to assist you. If you require more information about ALDHbr, please contact us at stemcell.com.